Aloha Kia presents Ohana Road, Hawaii's award-winning automotive TV magazine. Featuring all the latest and greatest cars, vans, and SUVs coming your way. Visit with celebrity car enthusiasts. A look at fabulous classics and cars of tomorrow. Go cruising with local cars and stars. With your hosts, Jordan Segundo and Rachel Picaro.
Aloha and welcome to Ohana Road, Hawaii's premier TV show about cars. I'm Jordan Segundo.
And I'm Rachel Picaro. And we're pleased to bring you another episode of Aloha Kia's weekly half hour of automotive infotainment.
So get ready for the ride.
This week on Ohana Road, we shine our new car spotlight on two impressive 2011 models from the finest car maker on the planet, Kia.
On Cars and Stars, we meet up with multi-platinum recording artist Kid Rock, a true car guy.
And on Car Mania, we go back in time to the sands of Daytona Beach, Florida, as we find out how NASCAR got started.
Then on Concepts and Classics, we bring you robot cars racing across the desert for a $1 million grand prize. All that and more, plus a bunch of Maloney.
So sit back and enjoy the show, because we're cruising down Ohana Road right after this.
Here we go, here we go. You can get with this, or you can get with that. The all-new Kia Soul, starting at $159 a month. Get with this, Aloha Kia. Do-da-dip-bitty.
Locked out? Need keys right away? Papa Lock is your mobile source for car door unlocking and dealer chip keys cut and programmed on site. It's quick, convenient, and affordable. You bought a new home and want to ensure your family is safe and secure? Let Papa Lock rekey your new home at a fraction of the cost of replacing the locks, giving you peace of mind. Roadside assistance with no membership required. Day or night, remember the name, Papa Lock.
Welcome back to Ohana Road. In our new car spotlight, we feature the newest cars from the hottest car maker on the planet, Kia. In addition to offering consumers outstanding quality, appealing new design, comfort, and value, the Kia brand is first and foremost committed to providing the highest levels of passenger safety, which is one big reason why the 2011 Kia Sorento was just named as Consumer Reports Magazine's top car for 2011 family SUV.
The 2011 Kia Sorento is all new from the ground up. It's been completely redesigned and now features a space-age unibody for safety and performance, plus a more powerful engine and a new third-row seat. The new Sorento is longer, quicker, and with a suspension that is fully independent. And although it's a utility vehicle, it drives like your family car. This crossover features a roomy and striking interior, offering an optional third-row folding seat with an impressive total of 72.5 cubic feet of cargo storage. The Sorento crossover is offered in four trim levels. Engine options include an efficient 2.4-liter four-cylinder engine or a punchy 3.5-liter V6 with a whopping 274 horsepower. A 6-speed manual or 6-speed automatic transmission is available with front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. A host of safety features are included and backed by Kia's industry-leading warranty, which is why the 2011 Sorento was awarded the top safety pick by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. The all-new Kia Sorento is not only fun to drive, it's one of the safest crossovers available. Check one out at your nearest Aloha Kia dealer.
So if you're considering an affordable, efficient, and super safe utility vehicle, then look no further than the 2011 Kia Sorento. And now here's Jordan with this week's Cars and Stars.
Thanks, Rachel. We've teamed up with the History Channel's popular automotive TV show Top Gear to bring you our next personality. He sold millions of albums worldwide, performed on some of the biggest stages, and was even married to a Playboy playmate. Here's recording artist Kid Rock.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Mr. Kid Rock. Have a seat. Oh. Man, it is good to have you on the show, man. Thank you for being here.
This is one of those fun ones.
What's your favorite car that you own right now?
God, I just got this really fun 64 Bonneville that this designer Nudie did. He's an old Western designer. He did like all the Hank Williams clothes, all the early Western guys, Roy Rogers, all the flashy Western wear. And he did about, I think it was 15 to 20 cars. Like Elvis had one, and Roy Rogers, of course, and Webb Pierce, a lot of country stars. And this was Hank Jr.'s 15th birthday present. And it came up for auction. It had been the Smoky Mountaintop Museum since like 68, and a collector passed away. And it's just, it's on the cover of my new record. It's, you know, bullhorns on the front, you know, 22 pistols that open the doors, and turn of the century silver dollars all lining the car and hand-tooled leather. It just screams American fun. In the fun department, I've won.
So you'd say you've driven some fun cars then, right?
Yeah, I'd say so.
How would you say the Suzuki compared?
It didn't interest me at all.
You guys want to see his lap?
Yeah!
Let's take a look.
This thing doesn't get off the line at all.
Not a ton of power. Plus, it is wet. This is pretty impressive.
Very wet. Look at the windshield wipers just cranking.
Coming into turn one here. Smooth so far.
Oh!
Try to take out the tires there. That's nice, though. Here we go. They're coming down into the teardrop. This is a pretty hard part of the course, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Come on.
You really look like we might be related when I see you in the car. Wow, that was impressive.
Suzuki, they should call this a Sapuki. This thing's garbage.
So not planning to replace any of your cars with the Suzuki.
Hauling ass.
By hauling ass, you mean 75 or 80.
I was up to at least 80.
coming in fast there to cameraman's curve.
Burn, baby, burn.
Look at that fierce determination.
Pretty smooth.
Yeah, that's impressive right there.
Come on, baby.
I'm not going to ask about that. Here we go. Coming into the... Wow, look at that lean. And across the line. Oh, wait. Oh, you're coming back. Wow, that was nice.
That was fun.
You were the first one to do a victory lap.
Right.
That's impressive. Now, if we look up at our board, you got a hobbit, a funny man, and an astronaut. How do you think you compare to those three?
I'm going to be really upset if I didn't beat them.
Really?
Yeah, I know this is all about having fun, but I really want to win.
Kid Rock, you did it in 1 minute, 40, 3.9.
Yeah.
And with the W.
Sportage, standard Bluetooth, sleek design, $199, no offset. Aloha Kia, do da tippity.
Wet outside, keep it dry inside with Wet Okole. Wet Okole, 660 Ala Moana Boulevard.
I'll see you next week, man.
You don't have to be a pro to love the game. The Kia Optima, official vehicle of the NBA.
Rachel, did you know that the origin of NASCAR began during the Prohibition, when drivers who transported moonshine had to build super fast cars to outrun the police?
Really? Well, how did that lead to NASCAR?
Well, eventually, the drivers with these fast cars all got together to race one another. And these races became so popular that they started charging people to see these events.
And the rest is history.
Wow! Who knew alcohol mixed with fast cars would lead to the most competitive racing events in the world?
Tell me about it. And in this week's Carmania, we take a closer look at how NASCAR got off the ground, or should I say, off the beach.
Welcome to Everyman's Racing Series, NASCAR Nextel Cup. You can't buy a ticket to a cup race. 180,000 people at Daytona, packed stands at Charlotte, Pocono, Atlanta, Sears Point. The cars could hit 200 miles an hour, and this is a far cry from the very first NASCAR sanctioned race conducted on the sand at Daytona Beach in Florida 50 years ago. Here's a look at that crash fest at the seashore. Pure Americana. No roll bars, half shell helmets, no safety harness, no Nomex driving suits, North versus South, ex-booze runners from out of the Carolina backwoods, the good old boys. And it grew to become a sport that made matinee idols of today's drivers. So while the Formula One dilettantes are shunning the public in their million-dollar motorhomes and the other two open-wheel series are at war with each other, the NASCAR guys are signing autographs, selling t-shirts, and doing network TV commercials. You've heard of Tony Stewart, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Kyle Petty, The Waltrip, Bill Elliott, Ryan Newman. Sure, you've heard of those NASCAR superstars. Hey, it's the American way. Someone once said, real race cars don't have doors. Oh, yeah? Tell that to the NASCAR gang.
Here we go, the Kia Optima, the only sedan in its class, with leather seats and 200 horsepower. $199 a month, the choice is yours, this or that. Aloha Kia, do da dippity.
Oh gosh, let's go Napa. Oh, check this out. Napa brake cleaner, just $1.98. Napa hand cleaner, just $8.98. Plus, get a free Napa racing cap with any purchase. With 40 locations throughout the state, Napa Auto Parts is helping to keep Hawaii on the move. Woohoo! Yeah!
For another new car spotlight as we examine the newest model to grace the Kia showroom, the new 2011 Optima Hybrid. With a stunning design, roomy interior, and class-leading estimated 40 miles per gallon fuel efficiency, it's a hybrid that everyone will be talking about. With a stunning design, roomy interior, and class-leading fuel efficiency, Kia's first ever hybrid in the U.S. is perfect for those looking for a striking and well-equipped sedan that doesn't sacrifice style, comfort, performance, or value. The Optima Hybrid comes with a 2.4-liter engine combined with 6-speed automatic transmission, a 30-kilowatt electric motor, and lightweight lithium polymer batteries, helping to provide a total of 206 horsepower along with 36 miles per gallon in the city and 40 on the highway. The Optima can be driven in zero emission, full electric drive mode at speeds up to 62 miles per hour or in blended gas electric mode at any speed. And while other car makers have talked about it, Kia has done it, creating what Kia calls a virtual engine sound system, which plays a pre-recorded engine sound during electric-only operation. It notifies people outside the vehicle that the car is approaching. So based on its sharp design, appealing amenities, and convincing hybrid powertrain, hybrid shoppers should put the Kia Optima Hybrid on the top of their list.
A car that saves you money and the environment? I think that's a great combination. For more information on the new Optima Hybrid, visit Aloha Kia. Now don't go anywhere, there's more Ohana Road right after this.
Morning, boys.
Uh-oh,
Okay, you ready yet?
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered.
Dude, I'm sorry.
Weta Cole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name, Weta Cole.
Welcome back to Ohana Road. Wouldn't it be something if a vehicle could drive by itself? Well, the DARPA Grand Challenge, sponsored by the U.S. Department of Defense, set out to conquer that daunting task.
It challenged college teams and automotive organizations to create a driverless vehicle that could navigate roadways and battlefields all on its own.
And with a grand prize of over $1 million, the challenge was well worth it. On this week's Car Mania.
The United States military is looking for technology that will transform the face of the battlefield of the future. And for obvious reasons, they want military vehicles to be driverless. So in 2004, the federal government inaugurated the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, Grand Challenge. 195 universities and high technology companies from 36 states and 4 foreign countries responded with a plethora of robotic cars, trucks, SUVs, and even a motorcycle. The mission was to leverage research and ingenuity to develop transformational technologies that will give our armed forces an added edge. DARPA offered a $2 million prize to the vehicle that could navigate the 141-mile simulated battlefield in the Nevada desert and come home first with no one at the wheel. Some 5,000 people attended. Scientists, technicians, race teams, and the media, along with hundreds of geeks, were all there to see who would win the $2 million purse. The event began with 42 teams and their space-age creations going through a briefing and tech inspection for the preliminary trials on a 2.2-mile obstacle course. Stanford University was the team behind Stanley, a Volkswagen Touareg. Carnegie Mellon University had the pole with their big Highlander. Though extremely slow and nerve-wracking, Stanley took control of the race from its main competitor, the Highlander. It was interesting to note that Highlander was also backed by two famous Stanford alums, the guys who founded Google. At the end, Stanley the Touareg, with its drive-by-wire technology, proved superior and won the event in 6 hours, 5 minutes at an average speed of 19.1 miles per hour. Its huge race team of Stanford students, engineers, VW execs, and general techies all celebrated by hoisting a can of Red Bull as their victory toast. Here's hoping that cutting-edge technology will create safer combat conditions for our troops of tomorrow.
Makes the Bermuda Triangle look like a kiddie pool. They say out here is where the ocean burns. We're here, right where you paid me to bring you. Question is, why?
I'm looking for a car.
Look out, ladies. Mater's fitting to get funky.
How'd you like to come and see the world with me?
You mean it?
International passengers must drive through security.
The World Grand Prix. 3 races, 2 continents, but only one winner.
Ka-chow!
There's an American liaison under deep cover.
No mo, arigato!
These Americans are clearly master spies.
Oh, you've got to be joking.
Lightning McQueen cannot win the race.
Instead of saying ka-chow, he's gonna go kaboom!
McQueen needs your help, Mater. You ready?
Is the Pope Mobile Catholic?
No one can stop us.
Friendships can be dangerous in our line of work, Mater.
there!
I'm sticking by you the way you always stick by me! Oh. It's the American spy!
He's getting away!
Excuse me, leaking oil. Sorry, ladies.
Boy.
Oh. Hey, that tickled me.
Here we go, the Kia Optima. The only sedan in its class. With leather seats and 200 horsepower. $199 a month. The choice is yours. This or that. Aloha Kia. Do da dippity.
Andy Bumatai, you're watching Ohana Road, and I'm talking to Arnold Dowling. He's a 26-year veteran, a cruise knight, but he's got a great car to show us. What you got, Arnold?
Sure, Andy, I got a 1954 Chevrolet Bel Air. It's kind of chopped down a little low, with a 383 stroke of blocking.
Tell me about this paint job. I mean, did you have to get a Filipino to co-sign for you when you bought that?
No, what we did, we painted that turquoise, then we came over with a rainbow micro sequence on it, and then we shoot the clear over it. And it's what makes
micro sequence. As opposed
it's
to
like
the regular?
Glitter. It's like a little glitter.
Yeah.
And whenever the sun hits it, it reflects off the sun.
You know, I'm sorry, but I keep thinking I see a motorized picnic table going by.
I think you do, Eddie.
Oh, good. I thought I was mixing medications. Well, you know, when they offered me the job here at Ohana Road, the last thing I expected, I'd be cruising around on a picnic table with Bobby Enos. Bobby, why a picnic table?
A lot of time on the hand.
What's the most people you ever had on the table cruising around?
Nine.
Nine people. Average weight, what about 500?
Average weight, about 320 pounds. Big guys.
Oh, that's not including the beer, eh, Bobby?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I'm just thinking, I noticed a couple of tires wore out on this thing here. Now, you actually drive it that much?
Yeah, normally we do.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Whereabouts do you take, what's one of the most memorable places you ever showed your table off at?
Waikiki Parade.
The parade? And who was on the table, Bobby?
Actually, just us guys. Everybody's afraid to ride.
I'm not afraid. Good fun. We got a beverage here. So you know what you need, bro? One motorized cooler to follow us around.
That's in the project.
Hey, Bobby Enos and the world's first motorized picnic table. Here's to you, bro.
Thank you.
Hey, you ready yet? Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered.
Dude, I'm sorry.
Weta Cole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name. Weta Cole.
Good friend Bill for your weekly dose of A Bunch of Maloney.
This is really off the wall. The stars tell you what car you should be driving? Come on now. A lot of people really believe what they read in the horoscope column of newspapers every day. You know, today you'll meet a tall, handsome stranger. It doesn't say the stranger's with the IRS. Esteemed astrologer Madame Lichtenstein, you read her zodiac prognostications in Midweek, might have some starry-eyed observations about people and their car preferences. She says Aquarius people are opinion leaders and probably drive a Chevy Monte Carlo. Capricorns are practical and successful, therefore deserve to drive a new Pontiac Soltis sporty car. Pisces people are romantic and mysterious and probably opt for a Chevy Impala or a Saturn. Libras are attractive and sociable, so they might wheel a Buick Rendezvous SUV. Scorpios, according to Madam, are private, secretive, and might be seen tooling around in a Hummer. Now, if your sign is Sagittarius, it means you're friendly and informal and probably own a Chevy Silverado. Cancer people are homebodies, family comes first, and they like to drive four-door Buicks. Leos are a bit on the flashy side, maybe theatrical, and like to show off in a Corvette or a Cadillac. Virgo guys and gals are practical and thrifty, and their cars must be reliable and dependable. Thus, might be seen climbing into a Kia or a Daewoo. Aries people, like Aquarius, are take-charge types and probably drive something red like an Explorer. The Taurus among us are considered strong and practical, steady and deliberate, and might be found behind the wheel of a GMC truck or Buick Terraza van for strength, commitment, and power. Honest, that's what she said. And lastly, we have the Gemini gang, who the madam says are chatty and full of fun and just may own and drive a Saab or Pontiac GTO. Do you agree with all this? Do you see yourself, your sign, your car in the stars? The madam do. I'm Bill Maloney, driving off in my Ford Galaxy.
Well, it's time to put on the brakes because it's the end of our show. Thanks for spending your time with us.
Join us next week right here on KHON2 for another episode of your favorite car show.
Don't forget, Ohana Road also airs Saturdays at 3 right here on KHON2. You can watch full episodes online at theautochannel.com or youtube.com. And log on to ohanaroad.net or the official Facebook fan page for more information and updates.
Here's what's on next week's show.
On the next Ohana Road, we'll still be going Hollywood as we take a look at the auto racing career of Paul Newman.
And for all you trucksters, we'll have some fun at the Los Angeles Coliseum.
Then on Concepts and Classics, we check out the sexy James Bond Aston Martins of 007.
All that and more, plus a bunch of Maloney. I'm Rachel Picaro.
And I'm Jordan Segundo. We'll see you next week on Ohana Road.
Go Mokulele, the official inter-island airline of Ohana Road. Jordan Segundo and Rachel Picaro's clothing for Ohana Road provided by the Blue Buddha, located at 1221 Kapi'olani Boulevard.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.